Today I've come here to donate money to build a police post. I want to say something about the Building Bridges Initiative. We know that at the moment, and based on the previous elections, which were based on the current constitutional dispensation, the winner takes it home. The winner of presidential elections takes power of governance. And therefore, the opposition is completely locked out of government. And I want to thank the Right Honorable Raila Odinga for the vision he took to shake hands with His Excellency President Uhuru Kenyatta so that they can unify the country moving forward. And for creating the Building Bridges Initiative. Because that Building Bridges Initiative is then going to bring all the Kenyans together through a constitutional amendment. And that constitutional amendment must look at how the main communities and all the Kenyans are included in government by creating positions at the top level of government, which is all inclusive. And I want to propose that by returning the position of the Prime Minister and the Deputy Prime Ministers, and retaining the Presidency and the Deputy Presidents, it will bring the main protagonists together so that they can share power. And if it is possible, I want to recommend that, because we have so many communities in Kenya, so that before some communities die, they can test power. We include a one-term presidency of 7 years, so that it can rotate all over Kenya, but not a presidency which is just enjoyed by two communities. We want to expand so that Kenya power is shared by all the communities by reducing the length, the term of the presidency. Well, I've never seen the NDP opposing the handshake. The only thing the NDP has been saying is that they don't want the Jubilee to be divided. And it is normal. You know, when a child is in a house and food is not enough, and you bring another child in the house to share the same food, that child is likely to complain. So Ruto is just a baby who is complaining, because the father has brought an extra child in the house. And therefore, Kenyans will decide. When Kenyans decide on a referendum, they will decide on what to do with the constitution. If Ruto decides to oppose the constitution at that time, because we cannot preempt what is likely to do, then Kenyans will decide. They will either go with him, or Kenyans will go with Raila and Uhuru Kenyatta.